What's up, everybody? Jake Fletcher here, and I'm coming at you today with some less commonly known tips for home buyers in regards to how to prepare for the purchase of your home when it comes to your taxes and your financial situation. So first thing I want to talk about today that a lot of people aren't aware of is when you go to a lender, they're actually going to require the last 2 years of your tax returns. And if you're a business owner as well, they're going to require the last 2 years of your business tax returns, okay? So very important, if you are self-employed or you have traditionally undocumented income, shall we say, for the 2 years leading up to when you want to purchase, you need to make sure to document your income fully and take as few as deductions as possible, because the more deductions that you take, it might decrease your tax burden, but it's also going to decrease the amount of income that you have, which is called qualifying income, that's used to determine how much you can afford, what your budget is for the house that you're going to purchase. So if you're self-employed, make sure not to take too many deductions. Keep a P&L sheet, a P&L statement, profits and loss, and make sure to keep track of everything so that it's as beneficial as possible to helping you be able to qualify for more. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is your credit score. You're going to want to increase your credit score if it's low, and it depends on the type of loan you're getting, what the requirement is as far as your credit score and your credit report. But in general, try to shoot for at least a 700, preferably more. The highest you can get it as possible is what you want, okay? And if you need to, speak to a credit repair specialist and they can help you get derogatory marks or incorrect things off of your credit statement, which can also help. Do this early because it does take time to get those things off of your credit score, all right? Now, in terms of your credit report, you're also gonna want to pay off as many outstanding debts as you can, okay? So let's say you have three outstanding accounts, one for $10,000, one for $1,000, and another one for $500, okay? So the action is actually more important than the amounts, okay? So rather than thinking, let's pay off the whole $10,000, think about paying off those other two smaller accounts first so that your credit report shows that you paid off two of your three outstanding accounts. Then you can work on the $10,000 balance at that point in time. That's going to look better to a lender than if you just try to pay down the $10,000 to, let's say, $8,500 rather than paying off the other $1,500 worth of two accounts. Next up, you're going to want to take a look at your DTI, your debt to income ratio. This is going to determine your monthly mortgage payment amount capability, all right? It's your monthly expenses divided by your gross monthly income, okay? Now, also, you're gonna wanna talk to your accountant to determine when you should actually file your taxes. So, especially if you need to file early to prove that second year of employment like we talked about earlier. Also, let's say your last year of business, your business did amazing and you're able to use that extra income to help you qualify for a higher amount. Super important, okay? I get it. You might be saying, Jake, I can't afford 2 years of limited or no tax deductions. I need all the tax deductions I can get. Well, okay, but if you do, then you can take advantage of all the tax benefits that are available to homeowners. So we're talking about tax deductions in the form of your property taxes, your mortgage interest, mortgage insurance for purchases 2007 and after, depreciation of the structure itself, home improvement deductions, green energy credits, and plus when you sell, you get up to $250,000 of tax-free profit if you're single. $500,000 if you're married. And that's just a short list of all the tax benefits. So it's a no-brainer. Last thing on the list, but one of the first things you're gonna wanna actually do is talk to a trusted mortgage lender. They're gonna help guide you through the process and help to set you up for success, because your success is their success, all right? So if you guys have any questions about this, let me know in the comments below or contact me directly. Let me know what you think if you're about to go through this process yourself. And I hope that you got some value out of this video. Sell smart, buy bold, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.